Hello everyone, and thanks for tuning back in. I hope you're doing all well. So before we start, as usual, I'm not a financial advisor, and all the content and information in this video is just my own opinion and my own observation in the market. So let's begin here with the Bitcoin price and what it's doing right now. We have this massive pump, as you can see here in the chart, and what a surprise. As usual, when we enter the weekend, we see since 2 or 3 weekend now these huge pumps to the upside, as we had also here and also here. Always a pump, and then towards the end of the weekend, a dump. So what does this tell me? That we shouldn't take price action on the weekend too serious. And yeah, what a surprise. I should have waited with adding some more shorts, but yeah, I didn't want to miss it out, so I added some more shorts around 3900. And now you can see here my entry price is almost 3900 and almost 20,000 contracts. I have a liquidation price of 4280, so I have another position here open, as you can see, just before liquidation with 8,000 contracts. So if this get executed, I would have a liquidation price of 4450, which I think is the maximum that we can reach here if we like see really some continuation today to the upside. Here in the 1 hour, if you see here the chart, it is possible that we are like now creating another bull flag. It is possible, but not confirmed. It's still too early to tell, but it's possible. So I don't think that we will like reach 4400 or 4200, maybe 4100, but I guess that we're gonna stay the whole day like this, up and down, and then maybe on the week on Sunday or Monday we'll go back into the main channel. Because as you can see here, if we would stay up in this price range here, we would have broken the main resistance. But you see this green candle happened today, so on the weekend. And I like to just ignore what happens on the weekend. So although you see my lines here, like this one here, ignores the action on the weekend. So this is purely from Monday to Friday, and in my opinion, this could be a potential fake out and not a real break through the resistance. So I have to wait and see what's going to happen next week before I close anything. So that's why I keep my short open. And as I told you in yesterday's video, I'm going to play this aggressively. So I'm going to keep this short open and wait at least till Monday, because in my opinion, for now, this is a fake out. If it's going to stay like this till the next week, then yes, then this could be a potential trend reversal here, because we first time that we broke this line here. But guys, if this is a fake out, be prepared to have a massive, massive dump to the downside, because we are almost at the end of this wedge that we were in before. So that point, maybe not even the 30, this support here, 3500 will hold. So I'm happy that I shorted so far. But if this is going to be a real trend reversal, and next week we see a continuation of this breakout to the upside, then of course it would change my mind completely, and we probably will go towards 6K up here. Because this will cause a huge rally to the upside. But so far, because today is Saturday, I say that this is a fake out. And remember, we have here a futures gap here in the futures contracts in the Bitcoin price. Remember 3940, this is the top one. If we're gonna open again the futures on Monday with this price level here of 4K, we're gonna have here, let's go to the 4 hours chart. All right, let's zoom in. You can see here was the gap from up here 3940 down to 3770. So right now we are like completing this gap, and if we stay here at 4K, we completely close this gap. So what's gonna happen next? we're gonna have a new gap down here, which can be easily closed with just dumping the price and then go continue to dump and go and close all the other gaps we have below here at 3300, 3400. One huge big candle to the downside would be enough to close everything. I was telling you that I was hoping that we first gonna fill these gaps below here and then going to fill up the big one over here. That would be like the most bullish case. But because we are now closing this gap first, and we probably gonna open then another one, another big one below the price. I think that this is a very, very bearish sign if you just look here at the futures gaps. So that's why I just see it to go down if we stay here around 4K for today and tomorrow. I think if we look back to the other weekends, we always dropped like on Sunday. So I think maybe also Sunday will be like a retrace back to where the futures closed at 38.90. It's not that far. I mean, that's just $100, but it is possible. But if not, if we stay up here, then I would say that we will go down and probably with a massive dump. You have a look here on the RSI. Look at this. 1 hour totally overbought, 4 hourly totally overbought, daily. I gonna well this is well actually so oh I'm sorry, I'm here in the futures contract. Let's go to the Bitcoin price on Bitstamp. I was in the wrong chart, I'm sorry. All right, let's see here. 1 hour totally overbought and we already are in a correction. Maybe we're gonna stay up here like here. So you see also the EMA ribbon, we're still far from this, so a correction to the EMA ribbon is very, very likely. Maybe not today or close, but maybe on Sunday or Monday. So let's go to the 4 hour totally overbought, as you can see here. Look at where is the EMA ribbon below 3900. The daily is almost overbought, not yet. So that's why that maybe be a bull flag right here in the 1 hour. So maybe we have another attempt to the upside. This line here is drawn included the weekend action. So if we look here, maybe the resistance is at 4100, you see, and that's why I think maybe there's a chance that we touch the 4100, but I don't think 4200. Maybe we're gonna reach this and bring the daily also to overbought condition. The weekly, of course, it's now still at the same overbought condition, and I'm waiting this to have a bearish cross. I'm still waiting. Maybe on Monday we're gonna have this bearish cross and then see a drop to the downside. You see also the, here the EMA ribbon, the weekly, it's now at 42.50. So maybe we have a chance to touch this point, but I don't believe that we have enough fuel to go to the upside here, especially not on the weekend. All right. So you see we are everywhere overbought and it's weekend trading, and as we had all in the last few weekends, always these pumps and then dumps towards the end of the weekend. I'm not really surprised, but I should have waited with adding some more shorts, of course, but I didn't want to miss out, so I didn't want to risk to miss out this trade, and I want to short. That's why I'm feeling okay with that. Even if I'm 30 minus, as you can see here, I don't care because I think this is preparing. This is how the exchange is preparing the price to drop quite heavily. I mean, we are at 4K. This is a psychological line that if we break this line and we see maybe even today 4100 or 4200, people will get crazy. Will get crazy, and I think this is like the perfect moment to just dump it heavily and break everyone's hope. And this might be the final capitulation, or at least like a disbelief rally, go down. And then with the next rally, maybe people, they just don't look anymore at the price. They just don't care anymore what Bitcoin is doing because they got so many times disappointed that they don't believe this anymore. But I think we have to go down again at least once to retest the lows, to close the gaps, to have the perfect setup for a bull run for the next rally up. at least towards 6K. I don't talk about 20K, I say just at least to reach the 6K level. So right now, look what the price is doing today and tomorrow. This is a very, very exciting time right now, and especially on Monday, what will happen? Because is this a real trend reversal candle, or is it a fake out? This is the big question right now. And if you're trading this, I hope you are in the right side. I hope you're in the good trade. Make profits, no gains, sorry, no liquidation. So be prepared for all scenarios. I really hope you're gonna do the right decision. And yeah, so far you should be good if you shorted or long it and closed in the right place, because we had this crazy action this week going on here with this up and downs. You see that I also have here a closing order at 37.70, just in case that we have like a big wick to the downside and then retrace back up. So I'm prepared for all scenarios, and I hope you are too, guys. So I'm gonna wrap it up for now, and I hope to see you in the next one. Bye.